So ChiIL Live Shows is here tonight, out in back of Lincoln Hall.
Yep.
And we're here at a very auspicious time. You guys just released your first disc, technically today, right?
Well, technically yesterday. It's done. It's out there. It's in the world.
Sweet. Yeah, we were lucky enough to nab a press download, so we've been rocking that for a while. It's
sweet.
Excellent.
Sweet.
Thank you.
Yeah, today's the first show. Today would be like the release show.
It's the release show.
It's going to be a big release.
Release the hounds.
Yes.
All right, so if you want to just start quickly and tell us your name and what you play, that would be awesome.
My name's Pete, and I play drums.
My name's Ben, and I play guitar. Well, bass guitar, that is.
My name's Brad, and I play Brad.
Ah. So I wanted to ask you, do you guys have any pre-show rituals, anything that you do to get ready for a set?
Brad definitely does.
Yeah. I like to go for a walk around the venue, and then I like to sit in the car and play drum beats and sing some scales, and then I like to jump around, usually around the van, and then jump on stage and sort of just like talk to everyone to be like, I love you guys, and then go on stage.
My pre-show ritual is to forget that I'm about to play a show. And so I'm really surprised, and it's really fun when I get to play.
Sweet.
My pre-show ritual, I don't pee the entire day. I try and keep it all in there and save it for the show.
After the show?
No, during the show. And for that whole 45 minutes, I slowly release the whole time onto my drum stool. It's awful. But I enjoy it. It actually helps me perform better. And sometimes I'll sing scales with Brad in the van as well.
Headliner.
Yeah.
Yeah, right?
Sucks for the other guys.
Excellent.
Hi. Then I want a sandwich. Come hang out with me in the room.
I don't know where these voices are coming from.
I'm on the roof.
Didn't know you were touring with a band of Muppets, right?
I am.
Big time.
Oh, you've got a spot at Coachella coming up next month. Are you guys super stoked for that?
Oh,
I don't even know what to think. I don't know what's going to happen.
All kinds of things are going to happen. I anticipate swimming and love and bike riding and hiking and heartfelt gazes of companionship.
Sweet.
Cars.
We're talking heartfelt gazes, Coachella,
swimming, luxury sedans.
Putting your pants on one leg at a time, really?
Two legs, one pant.
Yeah.
Sounds like a plan.
Sounds like pants.
So, all of you guys are fairly young. How did you hook up and get together in the band?
Craigslist.
Craigslist.
Personal ads. Yeah, really, it was just a lot of random hookups, and Pete came over to my apartment and played drums, and I just about blew it.
Wow, they almost kicked you out, huh?
Yeah, it was the best.
It was great.
So did you meet through school? I know you moved to New York to go to college.
We met just by being in New York, hanging out.
Through the city and in Brooklyn and neighborhoods and friends.
Ah.
Mutual friends.
So mutual love of music kind of.
Yeah. Yeah, people like that.
Mutual love for each other.
And Ben and Brad have known each other a really long time.
Ah.
Yeah, we went to high school together.
Went to high school together. In Tacoma, Washington.
Gotcha. So you guys knew each other way back in high school.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
Did you play music together back then, or?
A little bit.
So are you in a van, or are you on?
We're in a bus?
We're in a van.
You're in a van?
Van. One van, four bikes.
One van, four bikes.
Oh, sweet.
And one cigarette lighter.
Uh-oh.
And no cigarettes.
And all friends.
Friendships.
And a lot of garbage.
We get gifts in every town we go to.
Sweet.
I don't get any gifts.
You gotta ask them for some cigarette lighters next time.
Yeah.
I have a lighter.
We only use those to burn each other.
We do make fun of each other. With fire.
So you guys are all touring in a van, and yet you said you're all still friends so far.
Somehow.
Yeah.
Somehow.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're doing pretty well. One of us is dying, unfortunately.
Yeah, I heard that. The fourth member is passing around the virus.
Fourth member has a bubonic plague.
Uh-oh.
Yeah.
My brother Matt has some kind of thing that he's getting a while to get over, but
yeah,
he'll be fine. He's strong, and nothing to worry about. We all still get along really well. In fact, more so living in a van together, because you have to, and you get to know each other really well, inside and out.
Yeah. Now, do you guys write new material while you're on long van drives, or just kind of relaxing and enjoying the ride?
I mean, Matt reads signs out loud, and that provides a creative outlet for us to make songs out of sign names.
Oh, right. It can be really annoying, because everything you see, you have to yell out and say, like, Jim's Law Firm.
And then you riff on it and make up really random lyrics and comments.
I remember that one.
Yeah, well,
it's a real earworm.
Oh, yes.
Jim's Law Firm.
So you guys tend to play music out loud communally in the van, or you guys all have your own?
We're kind of into silent music, actually.
Yeah.
A lot of people have headphones on.
Yeah.
Unless you're driving, and then you just fade the speakers forward, and the driver gets to pick what he wants to listen to.
You'd be amazed. This guy can sleep. He can sleep through a lot.
I can sleep.
It's amazing.
I can sleep in the nighttime, I can sleep in the daytime, I can sleep in the afternoon, I can sleep in between the morning and the afternoon, I can sleep in between the afternoon.
You should
and
be
the
in the sleep Olympics.
I can sleep in between the nighttime and the morning. I can sleep when there's music on, I can sleep when there's music off, I can sleep when your computer's on.
Have you ever fallen asleep in a rock concert?
I can fall asleep at a rock concert.
Yeah, for sure.
I can fall asleep on a rock. I can fall asleep underneath a rock.
You ever seen Forrest Gump?
I can fall asleep while watching Forrest Gump.
butterfly shrimp.
Broiler. We've listened to the soundtrack to the movie Drive at least 19,000 times.
That's his fault.
It's my fault because I didn't have a lot of CDs in the car.
And you were doing a lot of the driving, so you got to be the
A little bit, yeah.
He
but
puts on the dictator. Too.
Right, but there's just not enough. There aren't enough.
What advice do you have for kids out there who want to be touring in bands, who want to be doing the...
Don't stop playing. Don't quit, because then you can't do it.
Yeah. It's not going to happen if you don't do it, you guys.
So keep playing.
You are what you say you are.
So be true to your word, huh?
Yeah.
That's like a...
Right. Now, you're the primary songwriter. Is a lot of your work now collaborative effort? Or do you work a little bit on your own instrumental pieces once the lyrics are out there? Or how does that work?
Well, you know, usually I just draft an idea, and then as soon as I've got a pretty solid idea in mind, I take it to the house. And then we fine-tune the thing, and we make it as good as it can be together.
Now, I read the concept about the whole time capsule thing, being a little peek inside your brain and being a little time capsule with an eye toward the future, looking back to where you're at right here at this moment.
Yeah.
So how would you describe? I mean, here you are right on the cusp. You got your first disc and vinyl out.
Now it's kind of the future.
Yeah. Every time you say now, I don't know.
Well, that time
I don't know. What should I describe?
Like how does it feel to have some of your dreams coming to fruition? To be on a major tour?
Have
a real solid physical disc out there instead of in your mind.
Well, I'll tell you, it feels mildly warm outside, and the wind feels pretty good. I've got there's a pleasant breeze, and I feel a really nice companionship with my mates here that I ride around in a van with, and I feel excited, my foot hurts a little bit, I feel just really, really happy. All you can really know is what you have now. So happy to have everything that I have here, friends, and really nice light, really nice people around all the time.
You are the one who has the band as a namesake. Is that getting confusing for you now that your star's kind of rising, or is it?
He does forget his last name often.
I don't know much about that.
So it's not too confusing when people refer to you or the band as one entity.
We are a band.
So you're all Oberhofer.
Yeah.
Yeah.
As a collective entity.
We all changed our last names.
That's why we didn't give our last names.
Yeah. All right. That's
not what happened.
So you'll all be the brothers Oberhofer.
Yes. Yes.
The brothers Hofer.
Gotcha.
We're brothers. Yeah.
We're the Broberhofers.
What can we expect from the show tonight?
Ooh, tonight's show's going to be really good. You can expect all the songs that you wanted to hear. And some that you weren't expecting to hear. And it's gonna be really good. Time's gonna fly.
Did you cover anybody else live?
Not
all your material.
Not tonight.
You guys.
It's all us.
Time is gonna fly. It's gonna be over before you know it, which is like you're gonna want more.
Excellent. It's always good to leave them wanting more.
Yeah.
It's true.
Excellent.
Everything he said. You shouldn't want too much. You should just let yourself be taken.
You should want what you have.
You guys have any closing remarks you want to say about your new disc or anything you want to say to your fans out there?
Yeah, I hope you guys all have a really nice day or a nice night or a nice afternoon.
Good night.
It's great to be in Chicago and here the jewel of the Midwest, and we're gonna do our best tonight.
Rock over London, rock on Chicago.
And, excellent.
The best advice is your own advice.
All right. Thanks for taking the time to meet with us.
No problem.
And have an excellent show. We can't wait to see you live.
Cool. Vita Sane.
Cheers. Thank you.